Right guys, let's start re-dugging again. Let me just climb over the camera and everything else. Right. Bear with me a sec. One blender. One mixing bowl. 2 medium to go containers, 1 box of Belgian chocolate cookies to start with, 80 grams of butter melting on the hot plate on a lazy season in a dish, of course, and 100 grams of chocolate. One packet of Belgian chocolate Belgian chocolate cookies. Place them in the blender. Get your lid. Stick it on pulp. Give it a quick shake. Get your bowl. If it gets stuck around the blade, just get a spoon and gently go around the blade. If you haven't got a blender, just get a plastic bag. Get a plastic bag, roll it in. A plastic bag, a rolling pin, and just roll it. Then get your spoon. Thank you. get to-go container. A sheet greased with paper, about the same size as the to-go container. Place it in the bottom. If you haven't got a lazy Susan for melting your butter, just get a pan of water, then get a small saucepan, put the first pan with the water in it on your stove top. Put the second pan in, put your butter in the second pan, stand the second pan in the water, melt the butter. Put your butter in. Right. If your butter's not melting enough, just get a little bit of water. Thank you. a little bit of water with your butter. Dip it into your mix. Give it a good stir. Now, if any of you chocolate sponge, even chocolate custard at school, and when you ate it, you mixed it all around, that's what you want, basically. Sure you got a cut. Get your container. Try and split your mix into two. Hold on, because I can't see. Where's my glasses? Take the second one. Preferably, you're not going to do it with broken glasses, as you've just seen. I've just broke my glasses. Hopefully, when you guys are cooking at home, you can see. Right, once you've done that, stick them in the fridge while you do the second part. Right, get a second container get a packet of chocolate chip cookies. Take half the packet. About half the packet. Again. Again, what I'm crumb like. Get your butter. Mix it again. Get rid of your rubbish. Mix it up again. Get one of your containers that you've left in the fridge overnight. When you do this, you'll either leave it in the fridge overnight or stick it in the freezer. You only want it to cool off so it sets a bit. Then get a probably 1, 2, yeah, go for 3. Smooth it out. Take it, put it back in there. In this case, I'm going to put it in the freezer. Just for speed. Right, so just put that one in the freezer. Now again. And about 3 again, if you've got 3 left. Push it away from you, turn it, push it away from you, turn it again, push it away from you, take it again, push it away from you. And smooth it towards you. Make sure your hands are clean. Now that one goes in the freezer. Now you get your milk chocolate and you melt that on your lazy Susan, or if you've got a solid hot plate. Melt your chocolate. Don't rush melting your chocolate, because in the time it takes to melt your chocolate, your biscuits are freezing. That's just to make them a little bit firmer for you to put the chocolate on the top. As you can probably guess, that's nowhere near frozen or set yet, but take your chocolate, one, two, and then just very gently spoon it over the top. Don't do this at home. Use your spoon, not your finger, because this chocolate is going to be hot. It's just I got asbestos fingers. I can take the heat. Stick this in the freezer and I'll see you tomorrow, because this is going to have to be in the freezer overnight. Right guys, here we go. Yeah. Take the paper, lift it out your container. Okay, it's still soft. Okay. There we go, look, you got chocolate cookie on the bottom with chocolate chip cookie in the middle and a layer of chocolate on the top. There we go, yummy, yummy biscuit. You will want to leave it in the fridge longer than I have. Okay. There you go. Enjoy.